would hate to die and never do the thing I was born to do. This life that you dream about is yours. That thing that stirs in you, that is something that you just can't shake. Every time you get settled into a career, something keep on bubbling. Something keep on, what is that thing? What you think that is? That's that seed he put in you since birth. But it just needs nurturing. It needs watering. It needs fertilizing. You got to watch it come up. And success ain't easy. You got to do some things for it to grow.
The wealthiest place on the planet is not in the Far East where there's oil and gold. It's not in South Africa where there are diamond mines. It's the wealthiest place on the planet. It's the cemetery. There you see potential never realized. There you find books never written. There you find ideas never acted on. Maybe that's why Henry David Thoreau said, "Oh God, to reach the point of death, only to realize that you've never lived. Only to realize that you've never scraped the surface of your potential."
King, don't sell your soul for material things. See, you gotta remember the reason why you started this. You gotta remember the reason why you put your blood, sweat, and tears into this. Remember, we ain't do this to shine on nobody. We did this to take care of somebody. We know what we want. You know what you want. To accomplish something they said you can never accomplish. We want more out of this life. No longer will we listen to the doubts. No longer will we listen to the echoes of people who never believed in themselves. We're not going to taste the dollar. We're going to taste the purpose. We're going to remember why we started.
Whatever discomfort you experience, whatever challenges or difficulty that it is, you got to handle it. Got to go up in there and wrestle with it. Will it be easy? No. Will it be challenging? Yes. What do you want me to tell you? That it's going to be a picnic? No, it's not. It's going to kick your butt? Yes, it is. Are you going to want to die? Yes, yes, that's a part of it. But that's just what you must go through in order to get where you want to go. And guess what? You are strong enough to do it. You're strong enough, and your life is worth whatever you have to go through to get past this addiction. Whatever you have to do, this dream you got, whatever you want to do, will it be easy to just run out there and do it? No. Will it happen overnight? No. Will it be a struggle? Yes. And then you move on anyhow. You move on past it and you do whatever you've got to do.
If you're truly going to be exceptional, if you're truly going to be radical, you have to be willing to stand out. You have to be willing to be hated. You have to be willing to be controversial. You have to be willing to have certain people talking about you, and you walk in the room and all the conversation talk, you have to be okay with that. Because if you're a radical, that's going to happen.
The problem is, everybody wants to be a beast,
until it's time to do what real beasts do. Everybody gets excited. E.T., the guru story, but nobody wants to get up at 3 o'clock. Everybody's excited when I say, I wake up at 3 o'clock, Eric's a beast, 3 o'clock. And then you try it twice at 5, and yo. Like for real, you walk out of here pumped up, fired up, you get some new information, you're ready. Everybody wants to be a beast until it's time to do what beasts do. And what you have to understand is, everybody that you're going to hear from, Eric Thomas, my mother got pregnant with me at 17 years old, high school dropout, ate out of trash cans, lived in abandoned buildings, slept in cars. Not only do I want to be a beast, if you follow my 24 hours, I do what beasts do. And you cannot, listen to me, I got you. You can't just say you want it. You can't watch the video and say, I want it as bad as I want to breathe. It's true to say it. But when it's showtime, when the sun comes up, when the sun comes up, you got all the books, you got all the tapes, you got all the access. Now it's time to hunt.